Happy holidays, everyone. I'm really excited today because I've been working super hard the last week on making a ton of holiday projects. As you can see here, we have a bunch ranging from really easy and getting progressively a little bit more complicated. So I can't wait to share with you guys how I made each one of these and hopefully inspire you to make some holiday projects for yourself. The great thing about these ornaments is that they don't require any soldering. They require no previous experience or knowledge about LEDs. They're great to do with kids, and they utilize our new fairy lights, which we got in stock a few weeks ago. So I'm really excited to do some projects with those. So for the first example right here, I just stuffed in three different fairy string lights in red, green, and yellow. And this gives it a more traditional kind of look. I got this clear ball at Michael's. You could get them at any craft store. They're really inexpensive. And I just threw them in there and let them kind of get all messy together. And it kind of looks like there's a Christmas universe inside now. You do end up having these battery packs hanging out the side, and you can just tuck those in your tree to hide them away. For the second ornament, I wanted to do something with glitter. As some of our more dedicated followers know, I love glitter. And I wanted to kind of illuminate it from within, but also make sure that the glitter was all the way around the ornament. So what I did was I took some Elmer's spray-on adhesive and I sprayed it inside of my ornament, and then I poured in some glitter and shook it all up. And then same way I did with the previous ornament, I just put in some fairy lights. Let the battery hang out the side so that it can be in the tree and you can turn it on and off. And I ended up with this really beautiful ornament. It was really fun to make. And my final ornament is for the non-traditional Christmas celebrators like myself, who might be celebrating Hanukkah. So this one I love because it's blue and white and it has snowflakes on it, which I hand painted using puff paint. To let it dry, I hung it off the side of my desk with a thumbtack. And once it was all dry and all painted, I just threw in the blue fairy lights, and now this one kind of has a different effect than the red, green, and white. Those are our ornaments. They are a ton of fun. And again, a great last-minute craft to do with your kids, and they really bring some extra spirit to your tree. Next up, we have our small Christmas tree, which I also was really excited to use fairy lights on. For this project, you're gonna need a slightly stronger understanding of electronics and LEDs, basic circuitry, and also soldering skills. So when I turn it on, you can see that there are three different colors of fairy lights. We have red, green, and white. And when we turn it around, you'll notice that they're attached to a Lily Tiny, and then a Lily Pad battery pack. And in order to make this work, I had to remove the existing battery packs that hold the coin cell batteries for the fairy lights, and strip down the leads, and figure out which was my anode, which was my cathode, and then wire it accordingly. So it did take a little bit more expertise, but again, a really simple project and a super fun one to do with the kids. For everyone's favorite part of Christmas, I came up with a bunch of different ways for you guys to play around with your wrapping and make them really fun and interactive and kind of surprise and delight your kids or your friends. So these are lined up from, again, simplest to more complicated, this being the most complicated option. I'm gonna walk you through each one and then we'll unwrap them to see what's going on inside. Our first project is a lot of fun. It's very visual and it's easy to do. It's just a bunch of LEDs in parallel right under the wrapping, and then I actually cut a tiny spot with some X-Acto knives to kind of let the LEDs come through the wrapping a little bit better. And then back here, hidden underneath the wrapping, but you can see there's a little break, is my switch. So I have access to turn this on and off in advance of the holiday, saving battery and making sure it doesn't run out before Christmas morning. Let's unwrap this guy to see the circuitry inside and what hardware I'm using, and also so I can unwrap presents. So what we have here, as you can see, are a bunch of lily pad LEDs, and they've been put into a parallel circuit using this copper tape. We have our anodes on the inside and then our cathodes going towards the outside. And then I added a little bit of solder to each of those connections just to make sure that the LED and the copper tape are connected. And then over here on the back side, we have our power source. It's a lily pad power source connected to the copper tape. And as you can see, I put a little hole here so that we could keep the battery inside the box, making it less bulky when you wrap it. So this one is really fun and really easy. And it just takes your gift wrapping to the next level. So this is a great project for beginners. This next wrapping is quite delightful. There's a switch right here, and when you turn it on, my bow spins. It's really, really fun. Another simple circuit. Inside we have a motor and a power source. This one as well, you're gonna wanna turn on right before the morning of, so that exposed switch is really useful. Let's unwrap this one as well to see what's going on inside. The first thing I'm gonna do is kinda pop this off because that would get in the way, and take off my ribbon. Okay, so let's check out what's over here. I cut this hole in the box so that while it was wrapped, I would have access inside to update the batteries or the electronics if need be. If something happened, I'd be able to access it from the bottom. But we can open it on up. And you can see that the components are kind of just put together. We have two AA batteries, a breadboard here to just connect all the parts. I have my motor taped up over here. As you can see, I have my switch over here, which I soldered my jumper wires to and then connected them to the breadboard. Did the same thing for these batteries. They're soldered down and to the motor as well. So it makes it really easy to make these quick temporary circuits inside of a box. This next one takes interaction up to the next level. When I open it up, you're going to see that some LEDs come on and the voices of angels. That's the joy that gift giving brings. The bag is a little bit different. What I wanted to do here was have the interaction happen upon opening it. So the light comes on and the sound comes on and it's this really fun moment. So I had to create a switch with the clasp. So I used two metal clasps, which is something you normally find on clothes, but I put them into this bag, and what the metal snaps do is create an electrical connection. And when I open them up, that's when the Arduino knows to trigger the sound and the light. So let's take a look at how I made this. First, on the back side is where I'm hiding my battery. And this just made it easy for me to plug into the Arduino when it was time, instead of having it plugged in for days in advance. And then I'm gonna just carefully unsnap my bag, like so. There's the music again. And if we look inside, what we have here are our two snaps, one on either side. I'm just gonna turn that sound right off, now that we all know what happens. Okay. So we have the two snaps and wires connecting that down to the Arduino and the MP3 shield. And then up top, we have a little breadboard with super bright white LEDs. These are also connected to the Arduino Uno and MP3 player shield that's inside the bag. For sound, we have a hamburger speaker. These are great little gadgets. They're very inexpensive and they give really great sound for their size. This last present is super fun and great for all you prankster parents out there. This is for anyone who's worried that their kids are gonna sneak under the tree and open their presents a little early. And basically what's gonna happen is if someone picks up this present before Christmas Day, there will be an alarm and it will be loud. As mentioned, this present is a little bit more complicated because it includes three separate sensors. We have an accelerometer, we have a real-time clock, and we also have the MP3 player shield. We have a speaker, which you can turn on and off from this hole over here. And then in the back, I also created this tab that you can open and close to plug in and out your battery. And this way you can keep it on when you want, turn it off. So let's open it up and check out what's inside. So here we go. This is a pretty clean one, as you can see, because I used our beautiful container here. And here is my real-time clock. It has a little battery in it, so it remains running and keeps real-time whether or not the Arduino is plugged in. Over here I have my accelerometer. Up here is my MP3 shield, and the Arduino Uno is right underneath it. And then finally, the hamburger speaker with some holes cut in the box for better sound, and my battery. That's all I have for you guys today. Stay tuned next week. We have part two of our holiday project series coming out. I sincerely hope you guys enjoyed watching these projects as much as I enjoyed making them. And please let us know if you've made any fun holiday projects in the comments below. Thanks. I love it.